Good morning, everyone. I am Alice Bertaina, and I am the section chief of the Pediatric Stem Cell Transplantation and Regenerative Medicine section within the Division of Hematology, Oncology, and Stem Cell Transplantation. It is with a great excitement that I welcome you all to this first international symposium on alpha beta T cell CD19 B cell depleted haploidentical transplant. Thank you all for being here today. This is an event jointly supported by the BAS Center that I am co-director of, along with Dr. Tanya Gruber, the Center for Definitive and Curative Medicine and Stanford Children's Health, and is supported by the generosity of Meltemi. And I'd like to start by thanking all the people who made it possible today to have this virtual meeting. I wish I could welcome you in person in this fantastic campus, but the pandemic for the moment leaves us just the virtual option. During the next 2.5 days, you will receive an update about the most recent innovations in the field of T-cell depleted allogeneic hematopoietic stem cell transplantation from 16 world-class experts, including 2 outstanding keynote speakers, Yair Reichner and Rupert Andrettinger, who will talk about several applications of this platform from immunodeficiency to cancer, from bone marrow failure syndrome to promoting immune tolerance after solid organ transplantation. This symposium represents a special moment for me that unifies the passion I started to cultivate in Italy since 2008 with the evolution of this passion that I am experiencing since I joined Stanford in 2017. I'm personally honored to have here today and tomorrow 3 incredible mentors who helped me in different and equally important steps of my career: Franco Locatelli, Maria Grazia Roncarolo, and Robbie Parkman. And I am humbled to share with you that we have almost 700 people registered from all over the world to this virtual event. I'm often told that the alpha beta T cell depletion was in my genes, since A and B are my initials. Not sure if this is true, but I love this idea. And as such, I really felt committed in being the one who first was going to put together all the amazing people who contributed and keep contributing to optimize a groundbreaking strategy of graft manipulation that now allows many children and adults in the need of a transplant to really get access to a cure. But without further ado, I pass the baton to Lloyd Minor, Dean of the School of Medicine, and I wish you all an exciting, fun, and interesting symposium. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Dr. Bertaina. And I want to congratulate you and your colleagues on the organization and execution of this really exciting symposium. You know, thank you for inviting me to give a few introductory remarks. And this opportunity stimulated me to go and read up on the literature, since it's not necessarily a field that I follow every day, but the exciting literature about alpha beta T cell depletion, haploidentical stem cell transplantation. And as you outlined, Dr. Bertaina, in your introductory remarks, the opportunities for impacting human health and for treating and indeed curing so many conditions, from hematologic malignancies to adjunctive therapies to solid tumors to, as you mentioned, totally changing the landscape of immunosuppression or the lack of the need for immunosuppression after solid organ transplantation, the opportunities for the impact of this science and this technology are truly unique and extensive. I also think this symposium represents really the finest of collaboration here at Stanford and indeed internationally. As you mentioned, over 700 people registered for the symposium from around the world. It indicates the interest in this important field and also really indicates the leadership role that you, Dr. Bertaina, and your colleagues here at Stanford and elsewhere play in this evolving and very exciting field. You know, I think we're living in the renaissance for life sciences today, and people will 100 years from now look back at this next decade, 2 decades, and see it as an inflection point in our knowledge and our ability to have positive impact on human health. And when I think about the future of the life sciences, I think about the convergence of three distinct but related fields, that when these fields come together, they can have transformative impact. And those fields are biomedicine, biotech, and medtech, the areas that we're traditionally familiar with for those of us who are biomedical researchers, but then combined with information science and with technology. And it's that convergence of biomedicine, information science, and technology that's going to enable us to have the type of impact that I think we all feel like we can have and we want to have in the future. I mean, just think about it in terms of the topics that are going to be covered during this symposium. One important next step at extending the reach and generalizing the impact of alpha beta T cell depletion haploidentical stem cell transplantation is the opportunity to dramatically expand and to routinize the manufacturing techniques involved in producing these very complicated therapeutic agents. And that's something that, you know, a lot of people are giving a lot of thought to today, and an area where this convergence of biomedicine, information science, and technology will play a major role at transforming manufacturing. Not to mention the fact that I think even before COVID-19, we knew that our knowledge of human immunology was growing, although still had a long way to go. And certainly COVID-19 has demonstrated that to us time and time again. Our knowledge both of the immune response of the host to the infection, but also, very importantly, our need for a greater knowledge of the effects and the actions of the vaccines that so fortunately have been developed for COVID-19, but whose mechanisms we still only partially understand. There's no question that these next 10, 20 years are going to be, I think, for all of us in our respective disciplines, the most exciting times of our career. And I'm just heartened by the great work, Dr. Bertaina, that you and your colleagues are doing here, and the work that we're going to hear about from all the speakers and participants in this symposium. So thank you again for inviting me to give a few introductory remarks, and back over to you.
Thank you, Lloyd. Alpha beta T cell depleted haploidentical stem cell transplantation was pioneered in 2010 by Dr. Alice Bertaina, who now leads the pediatric stem cell transplantation program at Stanford Children's Health. Besides treating children with malignancies, stem cell transplantation has been increasingly used to treat children with genetic and immunological diseases. The development of haploidentical stem cell transplantation means that donors, usually parents, are available virtually for all patients, something that was not true as recently as 5 years ago. Thanks to the close collaboration between stem cell and solid organ transplant teams, stem cell transplantation is now being performed prior to kidney transplants to eliminate the risk of kidney graft rejection and the need for lifelong immunosuppression. This revolutionary strategy will free thousands of children requiring a solid organ transplant from the need for lifelong immunosuppression. The Pediatric Stem Cell Transplantation Program works closely with the Center for Definitive and Curative Medicine in the performance of innovative phase one clinical trials of cell and gene therapy, including the gene editing trial for sickle cell disease mentioned by Dean Miner. There are more than 6,000 genetic diseases affecting 350 million people worldwide caused by the mutation of a single inherited gene, the treatment of which can now be addressed in coming years. The Pediatric Stem Cell Transplantation Program would not be able to offer these treatments without the partnership between Lucile Packard Children's Hospital, the Laboratory Cell and Gene Medicine at the School of Medicine, and the BMT Cellular Therapy Facility at Stanford Healthcare. The recently opened fifth floor at the Lucile Packard Children's Hospital provides dedicated space for cutting-edge cell and gene therapy clinical trials. It's not just a matter of putting up a sign. It requires personnel with expertise in creating clinical trial protocols, filing for new investigational drugs, and having clinical personnel with expertise in cell and gene therapy data management, biostatistics, and clinical informatics, and having sufficient ambulatory and inpatient space. The topic of this symposium is an example of how the integration of research with clinical care which can result in improving both the availability and outcomes of stem cell transplantation, will benefit both children and adults. It is my pleasure to now pass the baton to Dr. Parkman for his introduction of our first keynote speakers.